We can't have that. We've got our own things to do. Your things, she said. Aren't they yours too? Because of you, she said. Aren't they your very own things? Women don't have that sort of very own thing. Indeed, it's true. And think, you've been down there preaching the goodness of children, telling them the only good thing in an estate is happy, hopeful children, working to free mothers and children. And we give our own children to do it, I said. Yes, she said. And sometimes I think it's too much to give, too much altogether. Children get into a woman's brain when she mustn't have them, especially when she must never hope for them. Think of the child we might have now, the little creature with soft, tender skin and little hands and little feet. At times it haunts me. It comes and says, why wasn't I given life? I can hear it in the night. The world is full of such little ghosts, dear lover, little things that asked for life and were refused. They clamour to me. It's like a little fist beating at my heart. Love children, beautiful children, little cold hands that tear at my heart. Oh, my heart and my Lord! She was holding my arm with both her hands and weeping against it, and now she drew herself to my shoulder and wept and sobbed in my embrace. I shall never sit with your child on my knee, and you beside me, never, and I am a woman and your lover. 2. But the profound impossibility of our relation was now becoming more and more apparent to us. We found ourselves seeking justification, clinging passionately to a situation that was coldly, pitilessly impossible and fated. We wanted quite intensely to live together and have a child, but also we wanted very many other things that were incompatible with these desires. It was extraordinarily difficult to weigh our political and intellectual